you've been involved in a work-related accident, an accident that occurs while you are on the job, it's important that you understand your rights. Oftentimes, individuals that are involved in accidents where they're injured and they're on the clock or they're on the job think that their company has provided them workers' compensation insurance. Many times, the employer represents to the worker that they have workers' compensation insurance when in fact they do not have workers' compensation insurance. Workers' compensation, according to the laws in the state of Texas, has very specific requirements and is regulated by the state of Texas. So it's important, number one, that you determine whether or not the insurance that they have for you is actually workers' compensation insurance and not a work-related injury plan. Second, it's important that you understand what rights you have if you're injured on the job. I get literally hundreds of calls a year from individuals that are involved in work-related accidents. Oftentimes, those individuals have workers' compensation insurance and think that they have a right to go after or sue their employer for failing to provide them a safe workplace. But according to our legislature and the laws in the state of Texas, if your employer has workers' compensation insurance, that is your only right of recovery if you're injured on the job. The legislature passed these laws in an effort to protect employers and to encourage them to obtain workers' compensation insurance to protect their employees if they're involved in on-the-job accidents. Now, if your employer does not have workers' compensation insurance, then you do have rights to pursue against your employer for failing to provide safe work environment and for failing to provide that safe work environment that ultimately led to your injuries and your damages. Oftentimes there are scenarios where you have general contractors and subcontractors and you have certain workers' compensation that may have been provided at one level, and there's questions as to whether or not those policies apply or wrap around to the subcontractor or the subcontractor's subcontractor. In those scenarios, it's of the utmost importance that you retain an attorney that has experience handling work-related injuries, on-the-job accidents, so that that attorney can determine whether or not there is, in fact, true workers' compensation insurance and whether or not any of those policies are there to provide you the benefits that workers' compensation can provide you. And if, in fact, those insurance benefits are not available, then you may have rights and remedies to pursue causes of action against the employer or against the general contractor for failing to supervise properly or failing to provide a safe work environment that ultimately led to your injuries.